I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey whippersnappers, Brian here at Abramus Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip-hop songs using lyric videos, and then I let you know what I thought about them. Today we're doing OutKast, and the song is So Fresh, So Clean. So I did a poll of new artists to my channel, and I've been doing this all along. You know, there's been different themes, but, you know, I always put up five songs. This one happens to be artist new to my channel. And a lot of the time when I do polls, people will say, how come you pick that song? I just pick it off the request list. I don't know if it's good. I don't know if it's bad. I don't know if it's a hit. I don't know if it's popular. So I enlisted the help of a commenter, Mr. Hip Hop Head, and he helped me refine this poll. And I got more than one comment saying this is the most difficult poll you've created yet. And by difficult, it means, you know, all the songs are so good, it's, you know, it's hard to pick your favorite. So thank you, Mr. Hip Hop Head, for helping. Now, I have heard of OutKast before. They did that song, Hey Ya, which is very popular. It's always on the radio. And, you know, and I liked it when it came out, but, you know, they played it so much, it just got annoying after a while. If you're new to my channel, what I like to do is read a little biography of an artist, and then we'll get into the reaction. Andre Benjamin and Antoine Patton met in 1992 at the Lenox Square shopping mall when they were both 16 years old. They lived in the East Point section of Atlanta, and at Tri-City School they participated in rap battles in the cafeteria. Benjamin, aka Dre, aka Andre 3000, and Patton, aka Big Boy, were pursued by Organized Noise, a group of local producers who would later make hits for the R&B girl group TLC. The duo initially wanted to be called Two Shades Deep or The Misfits, but because those names were already taken, they later decided to use OutKast based on finding OutKast as a synonym for misfit in the dictionary. OutKast, Organized Noise, and schoolmate Goody Mob formed the nucleus of the Dungeon Family Organization. That's not a very good name. In December of 1993, they released their first single, Player's Ball, which topped the Billboard Hot Rap Tracks chart. Their debut album, yeah, are you kidding? Southern Playlisty Cadillac Music was released on April 26, 1994. Every track on the album was produced by Organized Noise and featured other members of the Dungeon Family. The second album, Atlians, it's supposed to be aliens, but it's Atlanta, so Atlians. They don't have any normal song, album titles, huh? Their second album, Atlians, or maybe it's Atlians, was released on August 27, 1996. The album exhibited a notably more laid-back, spacey production sound, taking influence from dub and reggae. OutKast's third album, Aquamini, was released on September 29, 1998, producing more materials themselves. Both Big Boy and Andre explored more eclectic subject matter, delving into sounds inspired by soul, trip-hop, and electro music. The album's title is a combination of the zodiac signs of Big Boy, an Aquarius, and Andre, a Gemini. Oh, okay. Aquemini. Yeah, Aquemini. There's no way you guys knew how to pronounce this when this album came out. 1998. You were saying Aquemini just like I was. Originally titled Sandbox, the pair's fourth album, Stankonia, was released in October 2000. The album was seen as a change in the group's musical style as it had a more commercial and mainstream appeal compared to their previous three albums, which were darker and deeper. The first single was B.O.B. Bombs Over Baghdad. The second single was Ms. Jackson. And about Janet? The album's final single was the organized noise produced So Fresh, So Clean, featuring a credited guest appearance from regular guest vocalist and organized noise member Sleepy Brown. I don't know if that's a man or a woman. The song reached number 30 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 chart and later garnered a remix by Snoop Dogg. Really? Is that a fun song? I like Snoop. Okay, let's get into the reaction. OutKast, So Fresh, So Clean.
Ain't nobody don't miss me. I'm just so fresh.
So this won a poll of very popular songs, and I don't get it. I didn't like it. If a song doesn't have a whole lot to say, isn't very deep in its lyrics, then I want it to be, a banger. But I didn't think this was either one. I don't know what it was. It was the music wasn't that inspired. The lyrics weren't inspired. It was too much repetition with the, so fresh, so clean. I don't know what else to say. I didn't dig it. Well, don't hate me. It just wasn't for me. Well, if you like hanging with me and you like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.